Hi everybody, this is Dr. A, and this is a bonus video on lab instrumentation. We're going to talk about MALDI TOF. So MALDI TOF is matrix-assisted laser desorption ionization time of flight, and it is the application of mass spectrometry to the identification of microorganisms. So this is widely used in microbiology, and so yeah, I understand it's not a clinical chemistry analyzer, but still, it's been widely used and implemented all over the United States, so I thought I would at least do a little bit on it. I think it's really fascinating. So mass spectrometry is an analytical technique in which the chemical compounds are ionized into charged molecules and the ratio of their mass to charge is measured. Each compound has a unique mass to charge ratio profile. In MALDI TOF, MALDI is the ionization technique, and TOF, or time of flight, is the mass spectrometry analyzer. So let's start with the ionization step. So MALDI was developed in the 1980s, and it made it possible to apply mass spectrometry to proteins. It converts peptides into ions by adding or removing one or more protons. It is a soft ionization technique, meaning the ionization process does not cause a significant loss of sample integrity, and it is the best choice for proteins. So the proteins remain whole, they just get ionized. The MALDI creates a single charge ion, which makes interpretation easier. It does not require an initial chromatography separation step, like seen in traditional GC-MS or LC-MS. The intact microorganisms can be directly processed to MALDI TOF without pretreatment, because most vegetative bacteria are lysed following exposure to water, organic solvent, and or a strong acid in the MALDI matrix. When resistant microorganisms, such as some viruses, bacterial spores, and yeast, have to be analyzed by MALDI, then a strong organic acid and or alcohols are usually added in a pretreatment step to the matrix. So you would have the culture that you set up on an agar plate, and it has yielded some isolated colonies. Depending on how fast the bacteria or yeast grows, this could be as fast as within 6 hours to 8 hours to maybe 12 hours or 24 hours. And so the colonies can be picked and loaded in the matrix and onto the target plate, and then that MALDI target plate can be loaded into the MALDI TOF MS system. And once you load it in the system, the runtime is only a couple of minutes. So pretty much you can get, once you have growth on an agar plate, this whole process takes about 30 minutes. So you can get an ID really quickly. So what are the steps of MALDI? So first, the sample is embedded in or mixed with the matrix. And then the sample matrix mixture is fixed on a metal plate. It's portrayed here. It has multiple spots for samples. The sample and matrix will crystallize as they dry, and then they're going to be hit with a very brief laser pulse. The rapid heating of that irradiated spot causes it to become vibrationally excited. Then the matrix molecules will absorb the laser energy and then carry the analyte molecules into the gas phase. But during that process, the analyte molecules are going to be ionized by being protonated with the nearby matrix molecules, meaning the matrix molecules are what's getting charged and helping, the molecules go into the gas phase. And as that's happening, the matrix molecules are donating the charges, the protons, to the molecules of the sample of the bacteria and stuff. So the most common MALDI ionization format is for an analyte molecule to carry a single positive charge. So here is a graphic that describes this. So in pink, you have the matrix that is mixed with the sample. The sample is represented by the little green dots. So that's some lysed bacteria in there, for example. It is hit with a laser. As the laser hits it, you can see the matrix comes up off the plate, starts turning into a gas phase, and it's donating protons to the sample molecules, and then the sample molecules become charged or ionized and enter the mass spectrometer. I keep thinking I'm going to sneeze. All right, the time of flight mass analyzer is the next step. So the ionized molecules are accelerated through a charged field in the time of flight analyzer, and this starts the separation based on their mass to charge ratio. They then enter the flight tube of the mass analyzer. There is no electric field. The mass to charge ratio of an ion is measured by determining the time required for it to travel the length of the flight tube. The lighter ions will arrive earlier at the detector than the heavier ones, and each will have a different time of flight. The intensity of each ion is also recorded, and then based on the time of flight information, a characteristic spectrum that's called a peptide mass fingerprint, or PMF, is generated for the sample. So here it is illustrated in this graphic. So we have the MALDI step here with ionization. You can see the samples is being ionized here, and then it's going to enter the time of flight analyzer, and then the smaller, lighter molecules will enter the detector faster, the larger, heavier molecules will go slower, and then it's going to produce this peptide mass fingerprint spectrum, mass spectrum here. And there's one different for each different type of microorganism, and the computer will match it up. So the interpretation. So using PMF matching, the mass spectrum of unknown microbial acylates is compared with the mass spectra of known microbial acylates that are contained in a database. And that database is going to be constantly updated by new manufacturers. For species level identification of microbes, typical mass range, mass to charge ratio of 2 to 20 kilodalton is used, which represents mainly ribosomal proteins, 60 to 70% of the dry weight of a microbial cell, along with a few housekeeping proteins. So MALDI TOF mass spectrometry identification is independent of culture conditions. So it doesn't matter what type of media the bacteria was grown on. You just pick in the colonies. You just need the bacteria to actually have been grown. So that's really a good advantage too. And then the applications. So it shortens the diagnostic time, often by days. The average time from sample prep to results is 30 minutes. The runtime is about 2 minutes in the mass spectrometer there. And the cultures are typically first grown out on media, and then colonies are picked and identified. It can be used to identify bacteria, fungi, and yeast. So wide application range there. It is suitable for high throughput. So that means running a lot of samples. And rapid microbial identification at low cost and is used in medical diagnostics, biodefense, and environmental monitoring and food quality control. So, all right, that wraps up our little bonus video on MALDI TOF. I hope you enjoyed it. I will see you in the next one.